heard, I haven't heard of like half these companies. I feel like, did I miss something?
A lot of new companies this year, I think.
What do you think it is? You think it's like, what's the new trend? I mean, I see these guys are spatial audio, persistent ecosystems, high fidelity avatars. Are we talking virtual beings? What are we talking about as like the trend?
It's the different headsets.
All right, let's go check it out. Hi.
Hi.
She's got RealWear. RealWear's good for construction.
Exactly.
And yeah, like put that thing on a hard hat and you are ready to rock and roll with your remote assistant.
You know your stuff.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Can I try it?
Yeah, of course. This is a brand new one. It has a thermal camera on it. Okay. So we're going to assume you're right eye dominant, but you might not.
I don't even know what dominant I am, but probably... Well, it depends on how close or how far, but yeah, right eye dominant's fine.
Okay, let's see if right's okay.
Yeah, it should be good. I'm here with the RealWear team, and these guys are here at AWE, but you know, they do a lot of construction and facilities management and basically all of the, you know, FM, corporate, real estate, and just like making it easier to communicate on the job, right?
Lots of industrial stuff.
You've got industrial applications.
Right. So once you put this on your head, you can adjust it. So I'll let you get it to your fit.
Great, the last time I had this on, okay, am I doing this right?
Yes.
Okay, the last time I had this on, I was at RealComm in Tennessee, I wanna say. So like in Nashville a while ago. And I'm always wondering like, how does the poofy hair do with the with the headset on?
I don't think the construction workers care.
They don't care at all. But I feel like it's kind of like I've got a headband on here.
It looks good.
It does look good?
Yeah.
We always wanna know that we look good, even if we're doing really techie stuff. Okay,
exactly.
So
this is a camera right here.
All right, this is the camera.
And then you have a display pod that you're going to actually...
It's too low.
Yeah, exactly. You're going to push it back and adjust it until you can see it. So
okay.
You're going to move it around. And this moves a lot.
I have no visuals right now. I have just... There, she can turn it on for me.
Is it on?
Yeah, now I see it.
Okay, so Emma, cool. Check it out. This goes all the way out and all the way in. So remember, you can adjust it to your perfect fit.
All right,
okay?
To my perfect fit. So it doesn't have to do with interpupillary distance. It has to do with like proximity
exactly.
to the eye.
Yeah,
okay.
You're gonna be like 2 finger lengths away.
2 finger lengths away. I'm like exactly there right now. And that's kind of where I naturally put it. So
it's looking good.
Yeah, it's looking good. You're
it
so
is.
Sweet. Okay, so what would this be? If I were to try to explain this to somebody, what is the equivalent of this in terms of field of view? Like I have a huge field of view, but this is taking up, I want to say this much, but at this proximity to the eye, it's like a large TV.
Yeah, for example, mine looks like a 7-inch tablet at arm's length.
Right.
Yours probably looks like a 10-inch tablet. But really, like you hit the nail on the head, it's really just like looking at a heads-up display. So if you have a job where you need to be holding on to something or fixing something, you're just glancing down and getting information.
Yeah.
So how this works is, I know you can't see this, but everything on the front of the screen, you see a homepage, right?
I see my homepage, my programs, my camera, my files, and my training. I had to kind of close one eye to see that. That was a little blurry to the side.
We're not quite in the perfect fit yet, but we'll adjust it as we
go. Got it, okay.
So for this, if you want to launch the camera, you would just say...
Launch camera.
Whatever you see
it
on the screen.
It did it! It yeah? did it! And I heard a little audio cue.
Right, so if you see on the screen now, you're going to automatically be in the thermal camera because somebody was already there.
Can we record this and can you send this to me? I wish I could show Kevin what he looks like. You're working hard, Kevin.
He's running hot.
You're running hot here.
Can you see my thermal?
Okay, whatever I'm looking at is... You're 24 degrees Celsius, but the camera's on fire. The camera's, you know, camera's smoking, man.
Lots of power getting used. So you can switch from the thermal camera by FLIR to a regular camera
okay.
by just saying main camera.
Main camera.
Now
you have to say it with authority. It's very important to say it with authority. Main camera, and now I see Kevin. I want to record you so badly.
You can, and I can send it to you.
Yeah, okay, so record video.
She's a pro.
Okay. And no training. I just put it on and it's simply just audio cues. And so that part's easy. Okay, sweet. And then if I want to end recording, I just go end recording, right?
What do you see on the screen that would stop the video?
Stop recording.
There you go.
We figured it out. It's so easy to use. Home screen or take, what do I say to go at home?
Navigate home.
Navigate home. It even did it for you, though. We were standing next to each other, and I triggered your headset.
But I said it, so it took mine.
Okay, I got it. Wow, this is so cool. Thank you so much, Kristen. All right, so this is the V2 of the RealWear headset.
Yep, it's the Navigator series.
Navigator series. So how much do these cost?
So the one you have is our premium device. It has the thermal camera. This one's $2,700.
$2,700.
Yes, $2,700.
Not $27,000. $2,700.
Or $27. Yeah, $2,700.
Okay.
And usually it takes place of having to fly somebody in and that plane ticket and that travel cost. If I need help fixing something with an expert that lives somewhere abroad,
yeah,
I can just remote in and they can walk me through it.
Okay.
So when I have Teams going on here, I get on a normal Teams call, my expert is walking me through how to fix something instead of having him fly in to help me repair.
One last question. Yeah. Does my data live on the device or is my data streamed in?
So which data?
Any data. What's on the device besides the operating system?
So anything that you snap a photo of, you can choose to store it to the cloud or to store it on the device.
And how does that work with like security, for example? Say I want to do this in a top secret place.
It depends on your company's security. So if there is EMM or there's security measures where you can only upload to certain places, it would be the same as what your security would be on the tablet.
Okay.
Yeah, and all the voice is not stored in the cloud. Everything is on board, so we're not using Wi-Fi to use the voice, which means we are not capturing your data.
Okay. I love it. All right, so RealWear, $2,700, demoing it here for the first time at AWE 2023. Thank you, Kristen.
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
Thank you.